Hello and welcome to the episode 99 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, we have radio and TV appearances, the shooting of a scene that will make Ringo as an actor, and the penultimate photo session of the Fab Four together. Let's begin with the 9th of April 1961. The Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, performed yet another night at a top 10 club in Hamburg for their second ongoing residency in West Germany. 2 years later, in 1963, the Beatles had a really busy day. The first task of the day was completed between 12:30 and 1:45 p.m, including rehearsal time, at the BBC Paris studio in London. The Beatles were interviewed live on BBC Radio for the pop-in program. They didn't offer a performance of any of their songs, but their new and soon-to-be-released single, From Me to You, was played during the show. If you want to know a bit more about the genesis of this song, you might want to listen to episode 59 of What a Fab Day. Having finished at the Paris studio, the Beatles were driven to the Associated Rediffusion's Wembley studios. Associated Rediffusion was one of the local televisions in the ITV network. Programs broadcast on local airways would often be broadcast on other TVs in the network, in syndication or at the same time, sometimes getting a national coverage. Anyhow, after a rehearsal started at 2 p.m, the Beatles appeared live during the Tuesday Rendezvous program between 5 and 5:55 p.m, miming a performance of From Me to You and about a minute of Please Please Me during the closing credits. The day was wrapped up with a live performance at the Gaumont State Cinema in Kilburn, luckily pretty close to the Wembley studios. In 1964, Ringo Starr was on the River Thames towpath, just west of Kew Bridge. He was there to shoot his Riverside solo scene for A Hard Day's Night. The other Beatles weren't involved with the filming and had a day of rest. It is funny that the scene that kick-started Ringo's acting career was actually a disaster. It was early in the morning and Ringo had come straight from a nightclub, drunk. Director Dick Lester and his crew tried several approaches to the scene, but nothing worked. In the end, Ringo just asked to walk around the area while being filmed. They did it, and it worked. In the anthology book, Ringo admits that his acting was so credible because he wasn't quite acting. He actually felt worse for wear. And I will feel worse for wear myself if you don't make me feel your love. If you're liking my efforts to bring you free music-related content, please head to www.simonmas.com/support and find a way to show me how fab you are and how much you care. You can drop me a line with a comment about what you like or dislike about my work, tell all your friends about this podcast and my YouTube channel, or make a donation via PayPal. No amount is too small and any help is extremely welcomed. Thank you! On the 9th of April 1965, the Beatles were at the Twickenham Film Studios for the filming of their second feature film, Help, or Eight Arms to Hold You, calling it as it was still known at the time. The band shot another sequence that would not be included in the final version of the film, set in a warehouse with the lads facing 12 thugs with Superintendent Glock and 7 policemen. Also today, Ticket to Ride was released in UK as a single, with Yes It Is on its B-side. It quickly reached the number one spot on the singles sales chart. In 1967, Paul McCartney and Beatles assistant Mal Evans moved from Denver, Colorado to Los Angeles, California. Paul left behind his girlfriend Jane Asher, who resumed her theater tour with an old Vic production of Romeo and Juliet, after the two had spent a couple of days together for Jane's 21st birthday. 2 years later, in 1969, the Beatles had their penultimate photo session as a band. The shooting involved 3 photographers and 2 locations: Madingley Club in the East Twickenham part of London and Duck Walk on the River Thames. The Beatles signed autographs as a crowd gathered around them and tried to look normal, although examining the pictures with hindsight, it seems there is something different in the band's alchemy compared to older pictures. Then again, they might have just been extremely tired of doing yet another piece of work together after the grievances of the White Album and the Get Back sessions. Finally, in 1970, Apple was forced to rebuke rumors that Paul McCartney had left the Beatles. With advanced copies of the McCartney LP getting to music journalists, much had been made of the accompanying press release. 4 pages of questions and answers that Paul had devised to avoid doing endless interviews to promote his first solo album at the time in which he just wanted privacy and peace. The problem was that the reply to some of the questions made abundantly clear that Paul wasn't missing working with John, George, and Ringo, and that he currently had no desire to discuss any future plans for the Beatles. Mavis Smith, assistant to the main Apple press officer Derek Taylor, commented that, "Although it is true that there are no plans at the moment for more Beatles recordings, this is quite normal. Next month, their new LP will be issued. It has already been recorded, so, consequently, as there is already material available, there are no plans for more recordings. I hope that the Beatles will get together for another recording session after the summer." For a few hours, it seemed to work, but as we will see tomorrow, it won't last long. This episode of What a Fab Day is over, though. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.